أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Welcome to Islamic Center of Rasida. We are here between Maghrib and Isha this time every night to cover the interpretation of the Holy Quran. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi Alameen, to accept. Ameen, Ya Rabbi Alameen. We are tonight in the episode number 6. From the chapter of Al-Qasas, the narratives. We inshallah will continue from the verse number 38. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still telling us about in the surah here, we are in the, almost in the middle of the surah. It's talking about the humiliation of Pharaoh or the Pharaoh to Musa alayhi salam. And the punishment of Pharaoh or the Pharaoh, Al-Fir'aun, and his hostess and his mala and his people. What happened when Musa alayhi salam came to Fir'aun? He showed him all the signs, the proofs that he is a Nabi, he is a messenger. Look what Fir'aun reacted. Verse number 38. وَقَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرِي. خربان. فَأَوْقِدْ لِي يَا هَامَانُ عَلَى الطِّينِ فَاجْعَلْ لِي صَرْحًا. فَاجْعَلْ لِي صَرْحًا. لعلي أطلع إلى إله موسى وإني لأظنه من الكاذبين. The Pharaoh said, Oh, chiefs of my people, I know for you no God but myself. ما علمت لكم من إله غير. He's still reminding them about الألوهية, that he is their God. And oh, Haman, Haman his wazir, second man in the country. Oh Haman, candle for me a fire on the bricks of clay to make a high building, a tower for me, so that I can climb it, that I can climb it and go up to see the God of Moses. Crazy man. Because I deem him, Moses, to be one of the liars. One of the liars. طيب. Egypt. They used to have granite. They used to have big rocks, solid rocks. That's why they built the pyramids from it before Fir'aun. And they make statues from this huge, highest still standing until now. From granite and from the stuff like this. And they said, no. I wanted to make bricks from clay and they make, we're still doing that in Egypt until now. Bricks from clay and they put huge fire for a couple of days under these bricks. It's gonna be red breaks. And make big tower for me, I will go up to see God of Moses. Crazy man. He's trying to create fake stories for his people to make them busy with the idea. Forget about Musa. Moses. At the end, they said Musa is just a liar. You know, he's blaming their minds. That's why Allah said, فَاسْتَخَفَّ قَوْمُهُ فَأَطَعُوهُ. He belittled his people's brain and mind and thinking. And they were stupid. They obeyed him. They obeyed him. For now, let's see, Fir'aun, he's scared from Musa because Musa now start, alayhi salam, to talk to the people about Allah. And he said, Musa gonna make brainwash to my people. That's why let me remind me them I'm their God before Musa gonna make a brainwash to them. And he said, Ya Haman, listen, make bricks and these bricks put fire under it and make a big tower and let me see Musa is correct or not. I want to see his God. Stupid man. He's talking to the stupid people. And just to make them busy about what is telling them, I am your God, and forget about Musa. And he said, Musa, just I deem that's why he's one of the liars. That's what he said. He tried to take people away from Musa alayhi salam. Look what Allah said, verse number 39. وَاسْتَكْبَرَ هُوَ وَجُنُودُهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ وَاسْتَكْبَرَ هُوَ وَجُنُودُهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا يُرْجَعُونَ. Pharaoh and his hosts, his junood, his soldiers, his mala, behaved with arrogance in Egypt's land, without justification, بغير حق, because only المتكبر is Allah. You cannot claim you are متكبر because it is not in you. ليست صفة ذاتية فيك. I cannot claim that I'm متكبر even if I own this dunya. Because I am nothing beside Allah عز وجل. Allah the one who created me, He is the one who gives me. I cannot claim. When you see somebody متكبر, tell him you're stupid. Only متكبر is Allah. We are all equal. We are all equal. Don't think you're متكبر because you have a position. Position will be taken from you one day. Because you're still alive, you're gonna die one day. Because you have power, you're gonna be weak one day. Because you're healthy, you're gonna be sick one day. You're not متكبر for what? Because if your power, your money, your wealth, your position, all will be taken from you. We never see any king or president or big man, big shot man in this dunya is going to the grave taking his power with him. He's going nothing with nothing. That's it. If you see somebody متكبر, tell him, you're shit. I'm sorry, I'm gonna say it. You're a big shit, yes. Because nobody is متكبر. Only المتكبر is Allah. And when you see المتكبر is Allah, the one is only متكبر, this is out of his mercy. Do you know why? Because Allah is متكبر. He's the only one متكبر. When you see somebody متكبر, tell him, no. Remember somebody, Allah, if you think you are great, Allah is greatest. You're big, Allah is bigger. You think you are someone, Allah is not. That's why don't think. This is, you see somebody is like Fir'aun, acting like Fir'aun, Shaitan, متكبر. Tell him you're nothing. You know, just make fun of him. صراحة, because التكبر, أقولها بالعربي, I'm going to say it in Arabic. التكبر ليست صفة ذاتية فيه. Allah created me, I say Jum'ah, I am weak person, I'm miskin. I'm gonna die one day. I am healthy now, I can be sick tomorrow, tonight. If I get some headache, I can't sleep all night. Crying like a baby. متكبر for what? How will Qazafi die? One of the youth, he get big iron like this and put it in his back. And he said, have mercy, son. For 40 years, he did not have mercy on any people. Now he's, have mercy, son. I saw it on YouTube. And everybody, look how Namrud died. Namrud ibn Kan'an. Namrud used to claim he's God too, like Fir'aun. People, they used to, with the shoes, they used to hit him because Allah gave him mosquito in his mind, brain. When mosquito used to move, he used to hit his head in the concrete. He never became caught until people with the shoes, they hit him on his head. He used to claim he's God. How Fir'aun died? You know? Look what Allah is saying. The Pharaoh and his hosts, they behaved with arrogance in the land of Egypt without any justification. No haqq, no right. And thought that they will never be brought back to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. That's why when Fir'aun, he humiliated Musa alayhi salam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gonna show, and he showed the all mankind the punishment of Fir'aun, how he died. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only al-mutakabbir, and he said in the hadith Qudsi, al-kibriya urida'i. The kibriya, the only mutakabbir, Allah is my rida', my clothes, my garment. والعظمة إزاري فمن نازعني في واحد منهم أدخلته ناري. That's it. If you try to be متكبر, جهنم. The only متكبر is Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And the كبرياء والعظمة, both الكبرياء والعظمة, the greatness of Allah, something good. This is the صفة من صفات الجمال والجلال لله سبحانه وتعالى. Why? Because all of us equal in the sight of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And Allah, if you try to make yourself متكبر, you humiliate someone, Allah will put you down and Allah above him. Like Fir'aun and Musa alayhi salam. Fir'aun said, who said this? وَلَا يَكَادُ يُبِينَ. You grow up in my balance. You don't know how to speak. Fir'aun used to tell Musa like this. What happened to Fir'aun? Sinking, drowning with his army. Musa above him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is message for everybody. وظنوا أنهم إلينا لا يرجعون. These people, they think, well, Allah, the one who created them and give them livelihood, they think they will not come back to Allah. Return them back to Allah. Hayhat, hayhat. They have to go back to Allah. Look to the punishment of Allah عز وجل to Pharaoh and his people. فأخذناه وجنوده فنبذناهم في اليم فانظر كيف كان عاقبة الظالمين. So, we seized him, who? Pharaoh. Allah said, punishment. We seized him and his hosts, his soldiers. And we cast them into the sea. Look then, how was the fate of the transgressors? What is the end of the transgression? What their fate? جهنم. In dunya, Allah punish them. And in the akhirah, still the punishment too. That's why Allah said, فأخذناه الأخذ. الأخذ لك. يعني سبحان الله. In Arabic, in English they said, we seized them and his hostess. But الأخذ, الأخذ بقوة. Like that Allah سبحانه وتعالى in one قبضة, one fist. Allah take Fir'aun and his hostess together one time. Under the ground. This is الأخذ. إن أخذه أليم شديد. سبحان الله. ربك إذا أخذ القرى وهي ظالمة. الله سبحانه. الأخذ ده والعجب الله. In the fist of Allah. قبضة واحدة. Come. That's it. This is called the meaning of الأخذ. Allah took them like this. Allah seized them. Punished them. But that's why. التابع والمتبوع. فرعون and his followers. Oh, all together. This is the قدرة of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And nobody can do that except Almighty Allah عز وجل. In one fist, قبضة واحدة. فرعون and his host, 70,000. With فرعون, few. In the bottom of the Red Ocean. And all of them died. سبحان الله. فالله سبحانه وتعالى, he's the only one, he can save people by the thing he can punish people with. Right or not? He saved Nuh عليه السلام with the water and he destroyed the kafirin with the water. He saved Musa and Bani Israel with the water and he destroyed Pharaoh and his people with the water, with the same thing. Subhanallah, see? But that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was watching Musa and his people and Musa and his brother Harun and he said, إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَ أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. I am with you all the time. I'm listening. I'm seeing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Pharaoh, فاليوم ننجيك ببدنك لتكون لمن خلفك آية. Today you're gonna save your body. He save eh? Just only the body of Pharaoh. يعني he's gonna die. But Allah will save his body. Aho, the body of Pharaoh is still here. It's still in the Cairo Museum. If you go there, go to YouTube and see the body of Pharaoh. You're gonna see him laying down like somebody just die right now. How many years? More than 4,000 years. His body is still safe. Why? To be a sign for the people until the day of judgment. If you want to remember somebody was arrogant, he claimed his God, remember Fir'aun. And this message for all of us. And not this is their punishment in dunya. Allah drawn them all into the bottom of the ocean. What about in the hereafter? Do you think Allah going to leave them? No. Their punishment in dunya, in this world alive, it was a preparation for their punishment in the hereafter. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ Verse number 41. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَدْعُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ ويوم القيامة لا ينصرون. And we make them leaders of evil. Who? Fir'aun and his people, his hosts. We make them leaders of evil who invited people to hellfire. And on the day of resurrection, they will not be held. لا ينصرون. Let's see the verse after that 42 together. وأتبعناهم في هذه الدنيا لعنة. ويوم القيامة هم من المقبوحين. And we have made them to be followed by a curse. يعني anybody until the day of judgment who in here remember Fir'aun, that Pharaoh, not the Pharaoh, not all of them, because this is the only Pharaoh who was bad, he claimed as God. People that think the Pharaoh, all Pharaohs, no. Al-Fir'aun, the one who used to rule Egypt during that time, the second, his name is real name, second Ramses. They have still statues for him in Egypt. Second Ramses, his name, his real name. And anybody used to rule Egypt, they call him like the king, the president, whatever the title. Al-Fir'aun. Al-Fir'aun, the one he's ruling. Not all of them, they were bad. Just only this guy. Because he was so bad. And Al-Fir'aun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we have made them to be followed by a curse. يعني, if somebody remember that Fir'aun, they will say what? عليه اللعنة. لعنه الله. This is the curse until the day of judgment. Everybody remember him or he listened to him, he said, فرعون لعنه الله. Yes, لعنه الله. This is what Allah said. That his لعنه is following him until the day of judgment. Everybody remember فرعون لعنه الله. Yeah, لعنه الله. أيوة. In this world and also in the day of resurrection, they will be among the disgust ones. Cast out with no mercy. طيب, let's see this ayat 41 and 42. What did I say for you here? وجعلناهم أئمة. What is أئمة? أئمة means imams. أئمة ruler of imam. Imam not the sheikh of the masjid. Imam means the leader. The imam means the leader.
and the imam of الإمام in the salah, who is the leader of the مصلين or not leader, the imam, they have to follow him. That's why they said المأموم أسير الإمام. المأموم, the followers, they are أسير for the imam. Whatever imam is doing, they have to do like him in the salah. For example, you cannot make ruku' before the imam. Until the imam make ruku', you make ruku' after him, right? And you cannot stand from ruku' bowing until the imam stand, right? That's why you have, it's a must to follow the imam. It's a must in the salah. And if the imam make mistake, the musallin, the followers, they have to tell him, subhanallah, exactly. Means you have to correct him. Means you obey the imam if the imam is correct. And what about if the imam mistaken? Tell him subhanallah or fix him, correct him. He forget to make ruku' or sujood or something like that. If he forget the recitation of the Quran, open for him. If you memorize Quran, help him. That's why we follow the imam in the, for haqq, while he's okay. But if the imam make mistake, correct him and say subhanallah. Well, imam must be qudwa, role model for the people, for the musallin. Role model of what? In what? In making khair and good, not bad. If you see your imam doing something bad, are you going to follow him? No. If you see the imam doing something, get to him, thank you, we're going to follow you. That's why Allah told the Prophet Ibrahim, إني جاعلك للناس إماما. Then indeed, I'm going to make you imam, leader for people, Prophet Ibrahim. And also, Fir'aun, he was an imam too. He was a leader for his people, but imam to Jahannam. Yes, but somebody going to lead people to Jannah, and someone going to lead people to Jahannam. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من سن في سنة حسنة, من سن سنة حسنة فله أجرها وأجر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة. If you make something good and people will imitate you, everybody will imitate and follow you while you are doing something good, you're going to take the reward with them until the day of judgment. Allah will reward you for all of them because you are teaching people something good. But ومن سن سنة سيئة فعليه وزرها وزر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة. If you invent something bad in Islam or bad for people, and people, they are following you in this thing, which is that everyone gonna follow you, you're gonna get sin, share the sin with him until the day of judgment. See? For example, those who are singers or acting or doing haram stuff, and you see the youth, they are following them, they became role model for some youth, and they are, he's my role model, and he's, I follow him, this actor, this actress, this soccer player, and whatever. The youth, they take them as a role model now. And these people, they're going to get the sin of what they are doing if they do something haram of those who are following them. But if somebody makes something good and they will follow him, he will share the reward of these people until the day of judgment. That's why Mr. Fir'aun, he was the leader of his people to Jahannam. He's the one who used to call them to Jahannam. And they were stupid, they followed him. لِيَحْمِلُوا أَوْزَارَهُمْ كَامِلَةً يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. They will carry their own sin, the day of judgment, all of their own sin, وَمِنْ أَوْزَارِ الَّذِينَ أَضُلُّنَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. And also, the sin of those who've been following them. They're gonna carry this all. Fir'aun, the Pharaoh, and his hosts, his people, they were very bad example for evil and doing dalal, misguidance. That's why يقدم قومه يوم القيامة فأورادهم النار. He's gonna be their leader in Jahannam. You're gonna see the followers of Fir'aun and he's in the top. يلا, he used to follow him in dunya, follow him in the akhirah too, Jahannam. يلا, يلا Jahannam. Those who are killing people, Arhab, terrors, Jabarut, those who are shedding blood of people, these people will go to Jahannam inshallah. And in the hereafter, Fir'aun, he's gonna be the leader of their people too in Jahannam. ويوم القيامة لا ينصرون. They will never have any mercy or somebody to help them. Verse number 42, Allah said, وَأَتْبَعْنَاهُمْ فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا لَعْنَةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, anybody after Fir'aun, he remember him and mention his name, he said, لعنة, لعنة on him. عليه اللعنة, curse on him. Until the day of judgment. And what is the meaning of اللعنة, the curse? He will be out of the mercy of Allah, like shaitan. Mal'oon means what? Out of Allah's mercy. Somebody mal'oon, being cursed, the curse on him means he's out of Allah's mercy. Like Fir'aun, like Shaitan, all of that. And this is in dunya, in this world of life. What about in the hereafter? And whatever that la'na in dunya, it's a preparation for him for the punishment for eternity in the hereafter. وَإِنَّ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا عَذَابًا دُونَ ذَلِكَ. نعم. ويوم القيامة هم من المقبوحين. الله سبحانه وتعالى said in the day of judgment, these people will be among the disgust ones, cast out with no mercy. What's min مقبوحين؟ مقبوح somebody he has ugly face. Ugly face, يعني if somebody like has beautiful face, you see the day of judgment, his face will be different. Disgust. Something you don't want to look at it. You're going to see his lips will go down, his upper lips like this, with the, you're going to see the teeth and the blood and all of that. He says, look, shaitan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. تشوهت وجوههم, their faces is not looking good. And the Quran mentioned that in too many ayat about this kuffar. For example, Surah Abasa, verse number 40 and 41. Allah said, يوم تبيض وجوه وتسود وجوه. You're going to see some faces in the day of judgment shining, brightening. May Allah make us amongst them. MashaAllah. And some faces, عليها غبرة. غبرة means dirty. مقبوحة. Dirty and disgust. مؤرفة. You cannot even look at it. And Allah said also, وجوه يومئذ عليها غبرة ترهقها قطرة. طيب. وهي said in Surah Taha, verse 102, ونحشر المجرمين يومئذ زرقا. Allah will resurrect the criminals, their faces and their body blue, the skin. And that blue color, like if somebody, when you hit someone, you're going to see kadamat, you're going to see the spots, blue spots like this. Might be because the malaika, they will beat them up, and you're going to see their faces will be blue. And the blue color means out of fear. Remember some of the big armies, they used to, the hosts or the soldiers, they used to paint their faces with blue color. Why? To scare their enemy. When they look at them with blue color, they scare them. And that blue color is showing people that fear. And Allah mentioned it in the Quran. And they said also the blood color for what? Something also you don't like to see. It's like something is not makes you happy. You know? So anyway, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. طيب. Let's see verse number 43. وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَهْلَكْنَا الْقُرُونَ الْأُولَى. Now Allah is talking about Sayyidina Musa and the Torah. بصائر للناس وهدى ورحمة. The job of the Torah, بصائر, enlightenment to the people. وهدى, guidance. رحمة, protection. لعلهم يتذكرون. If they became heedless, this Torah will bring them back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we destroyed previous disbelieving nations before Musa. Who like who? People of Nuh, before Musa. People of Ad and Thamud, before Musa. Allah destroyed these people. طيب. During the Ad and Thamud and these people, it was no war, fighting, like during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And these people, they used to ask their anbiya, like Sayyidina Nuh, like Sayyidina Salih, Hud, Ad and Thamud, they used to ask for what? For miracles. If they ask for miracles and they deny it, Allah destroy all of them. Like the flood with the people of Nuh, Sa'iqa, Rajfa, Allah destroy the people of Sa'iqa. Why? Because general punishment. Why? Because they ask for miracles. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no. There is no general punishment during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? Because Rasulullah ma'moon ala ummati. Rasulullah is message to all mankind. If Allah gonna destroy, he gonna destroy all mankind because they disobeyed Rasul. But Allah said no. Because Rasulullah amongst you, I will not punish you all. We're gonna punish individually people. But during the time of Sayyidina صالح, هود, عاد, ثمود, لوط, نوح, على طول. You ask for miracle, you deny, على طول. اضرب, خلاص فيش. ايوه. فthat's why we have to understand this. And we gave Prophet Moses the scripture, the Torah, which has enlightenment to the children of Israel and has benefit and mercy to them, so that they remember Allah's mercy upon them and be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us hint about the Torah here. As I told you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to destroy people before. And they said, فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ حَصِبًا وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتُ الصَّيْحَةَ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضَ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلُمُهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the prophet. Allah gave him order to fight those who are bad. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not want to punish all the human beings, because Rasulullah, Allah sent him to all mankind. That's why to fight individual. And the fight in Islam for defense, not to attack people or take their property. But Rasulullah was rahma lil alamin. Also, Allah said, now, وَمَا كُنْتَ بِجَانِبِ الْغَرْبِيِّ Verse number 44. وَمَا كُنْتَ Allah telling Rasulullah now. Now Allah is talking to Rasulullah in this ayat. وَمَا كُنْتَ بِجَانِبِ الْغَرْبِيِّ إِذْ قَضَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَى الْأَمْرَ وَمَا كُنْتَ مِنَ الشَّاهِدِينَ And you, O Prophet Muhammad, were not there by the western side of the Mount Tur of Sinai. When we gave Prophet Moses the mission, Risala, and you did not witness it, so they can tell you about that. Ahumma, they claim that somebody was teaching Rasulullah this Quran. Rasulullah was illiterate, and his ummah, his nation followers were illiterate, ummah ummiyyah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not there when Allah was talking to Musa. Allah, the one who told Rasulullah that. And nobody taught Rasulullah that because Rasulullah, he never read book, a book. Or he never sit with anybody from the people of the book before to teach him that. This news comes from Allah direct to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah was not there witnessing Musa alayhi salam in the western side of the Tur in Sinai in Egypt. Rasulullah never been there. And to witness that Allah giving him. Who told Rasulullah that? Allah Azza wa Jal, yes. ولكن, verse number 45. ولكن أنشأنا قرونا فتطاول عليهم العمر وما كنت ثاويا في أهل مدينة تتلو عليهم أو تتلو وما كنت ثاويا في أهل مدينة تتلو عليهم آياتنا ولكن كنا مرسلين And we created many generations after Prophet Moses. So a long time has passed over from Musa and 600 years to Jesus 600 years again to Jesus to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. See, long time, too many generations. Allah created, and you were not living among the people of Madian. Rasulullah never went to Jordan to sit with the people of Madian when Musa alaihi wasallam was a shepherd there. And the people of Madian, they are the people of Prophet Shu'aib. And these people, all of them, most of them, they used to write and read. They used to live in Jordan. And Rasulullah was not learning from them how to write and to read. He was not there during that time. He did not tell them anything. They did not tell him anything. He was not there even, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How he knew this news about Musa alayhi salam. And you know the story when he found these two girls. And you know, as I told you before, Rasulullah was not there. Who told him this news? Allah Azza wa Jal. Aywa. And he said, to recite our verses to them, in fact, we have sent you as a messenger, O Muhammad. All of this information about Musa, about Fir'aun, about the mission of Musa in the mountain of Tur, about when he was in Madian, all of this. Rasulullah never learned from anybody. Nobody told him about it because he was illiterate. He never read and write. Nobody taught him. This is direct from Allah through Jibreel and the Quran to Rasulullah sallam. And they have revealed all of this past information to you. Who did? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Last verse will make the Aqama tonight. وَمَا كُنْتَ بِجَانِبِ الطُّورِ إِذْ نَادَيْنَا ولكن رحمة من ربك لتنذر قوما ما أتاهم من نذير من قبلك لعلهم يتذكرون. And you, O Muhammad, صلى الله عليه وسلم, were not at the Mount of Tur with Prophet Moses, but all of these revelations are from the mercy of your Lord, Allah, so that you warn people who did not have a warner before you. And they can appreciate the blessings you came with and avoid the evil you warn them about. This is the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I told you, he was not there with the people of Madian. He was not there with Musa alayhi salam when he was talking to Allah. He was not there at all. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was not there also when he saw all of these What happened with Bani Israel in the mountain of Tur, Al-Ahdas, all of these from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? To warn the people of Mecca. To warn them about that. Might be they will get out of their heedlessness and they're going to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to listen, to obey, to get the message. For Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nobody taught him. It is the message of Allah. Allah, the one who told him this information directly. About Musa, about Bani Israel, about Fir'aun, about the mission, about his message, and all of that from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the way Allah Azza wa Jalla gave Musa Torah as a mercy, as a rahmah, as a guidance, Allah is giving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the Holy Quran also
And he's warning people with the Quran, might be they will get out of their headlessness and they will listen. Inshallah, we'll continue tomorrow. JazakAllah khair.